Hi, this is Dr. Rao. Let's take a look at an exercise in which we have investments in IBM stocks, and let's look at the details. We've been told that this is an equity investment, which means it's investment in stocks, and we're going to value it at fair value through net income, which means obviously I have less than 20% investment in this company. I do not have significant influence. The accounting records of Jamaican Importers at January 1, 2024 included the following information. Investment in IBM stocks. I paid $1,345,000. I have an adjustment, downward adjustment. It's a credit. So I'm saying less fair value adjustment of 145. So basically on December 31st, 2023, I'd say the fair value is only 1.2 million. Next, I'm told that no changes occurred during 2024 in the investment portfolio. What this sentence means is I did not buy or sell any IBM stocks. What I had purchased, that's all I have. That's all that's there in my portfolio. Now, with that information in place, I'm asked to prepare the appropriate adjusting entry at December 31st, 2024, that's at the end of the year, assuming the fair value of the IBM shares are three different cases. One, it is 1,175. The second is it's 1,275, and the third is it's 1,375. So let's take each one of these individually and see how we will handle it. Once you see the first one, the rest of them should follow suit. Now, all they've asked us is for the journal entry. I've showed you a little more so that we can understand the entire portfolio, how we manage this portfolio, the accounting aspect, obviously. So to start with, the fair value on 1/1/24, we had said was 1.2 million. I got the number from here. Now, let me highlight this number over here. This 1.2 million, what you will see is, I have the same number everywhere because this is the number from, it's a historical number. So when I'm at December 31st, 2024, what was the number on January 1, 2024? It's 1.2 million. It's not going to change regardless of what the number is on December 31st. So this is at a point in time, this was valued at 1.2. So that fair value I've written down for all three cases, the same number. Now let's take the first one. They've said, well, what if it dropped to 1,175,000? That's the new fair value. So from January 1 to December 31, it's dropped by another 25. So I have a decrease of 25,000. My fair value has gone down by 25,000. So in this case, I have an unrealized loss. Remember, this is not a realized loss. I didn't sell it. I'm still keeping this in my portfolio. It's an unrealized loss. So here I will, on December 31st, the journal entry is going to be unrealized loss debit. Losses are always debited. And fair value adjustment credited. And that's going to be for this 25,000. So my journal entry is loss debit, fair value adjustment credit for 25,000. Now in the T account, I have this $45,000. I have this $145,000 number over here. From this journal entry, I will post $25,000 on the credit side, which means my new balance now is $170,000. So for the fair value adjustment, it's a credit balance. Remember the investment account, it's an asset with a normal debit balance. If the adjustment account has a credit balance, I need to subtract it. So my balance sheet on December 31st, this is what it's going to look like. Investment account, the 1.345 million. Remember, that number is not going to change. That's how much I paid for it. The fair valuation account, I'm now saying is 170, a credit balance, which means in the balance sheet, I'm saying the fair value is 1,175,000. And that is the number that I wanted to get to. The goal was to bring this number down to 1,175,000. So again, start with Fair value at the beginning of the year was 1.2 million. If fair value at the end of the year is 1,175,000, it has gone down by 25. The journal entry is to record a loss, another loss of 25, bringing the total loss to 170. And you get the number down to what was given over here. Let's do the same thing for this one. They've told us that the fair value is 1,275,000. Remember, it's still lower than this 1,345,000. Let's bring that number down over here. Now, last year I'd said it was 1.2 million. Now I'm saying it's 1.27. So it's slightly better news than what I'd like to hear. What I want to say is I want my value to be at one, what I paid or higher. But at least it's not as bad as last year. It's improved by 75. So from last year's 1.2 to this year's 1.275, I have a gain. Here I'd said I had a loss. Here I'm saying I have a gain in the second case. So in my journal entry, what I'll have over here now is fair value adjustment debit, unrealized gain credit, and that's going to be for the 75,000. Let's see if this works out. Fair value adjustment is debited, 75. So on the debit side, I post the 75. I had a credit of 145. I debited 75, which means it leaves me with 70, a credit balance. Credit still means I'm subtracting. So let's see in my balance sheet if it works out. My investment, again, what I paid is 1,345,000. Now I'm saying I have 70,000 in this account, which brings it down to 1,275,000. That's the number I wanted over here. So again, compared to last year, I'm slightly better off, but still I'm lower than what I paid. Now let's look at the third case. Here I'm saying I have 1,375,000. That's the fair value at the end of the year. Last year I'd said the fair value was 1.2. Now I'm saying the fair value is 1.375, which means it's gone up by 175 compared to last year. And also now, if you look at that original number, what I paid, it's gone up compared to that as well. So let's see again what we will do. So I have a gain of 175 compared to what I said I was last year, the position I had last year. So in my journal entry, I will debit fair value adjustment, I will credit the unrealized gain, and that's for 175. Again, let's take a look at what we need to do. Fair value adjustment debit, 175. Now when you look at the T account, I'm left with a debit balance of 30. In the balance sheet, what's going to happen? Let's take a look over here. Investment is 1,345,000. That's how much I paid. Remember, that number didn't change. Now I have a debit balance of 30. So here, see the word add. I'm adding 30, bringing this to 1.375, and that was the goal over here. So the easiest way to work through with this exercise, all that they've asked you is for the journal entry. Compare the new market value or fair value to the old fair value. Compare the new and the old. If it has gone up, you have a gain. If it has gone down, you have a loss. That's what goes into the journal entry. So this exercise, it should seem very familiar. This is similar to your allowance for doubtful accounts with the accounts receivable, the valuation accounts that you have. So it's a similar concept to the allowance for doubtful account. So with this, we'll move on to the next exercise.